So we're going out in the woods, and I'm gonna show you how to build a solar still in the woods. Now you're saying, Ranger Jason, my mom and dad are not gonna be happy if I go out and dig a big hole in my yard, okay? Or I don't have the ability to do that. That's okay, I'm gonna share a link here with you where you can do a project at home right in your own kitchen with some household items, and you can make your very own solar still. All you need to do is take it outside where it's a nice sunny spot, set it in the sun and let it do its thing. So follow the links on making a do-it-yourself solar still in your home if you cannot go outside and practice in the wilderness like I'm getting ready to show you. But it's very simple, just follow the steps. Hey guys, Ranger Jason here down by the lake at Ligon Outdoor Center. It's one of the most beautiful spots in the world. It's very much my happy spot, and I hope it is yours too, just from looking around. We're talking about collecting fresh drinking water when you're out in the woods, survival situations. What are you going to do? How are you going to get drinking water if you run out, if you're lost in the woods, all that sort of thing. So obviously we have a large lake here, okay? All kinds of fresh water. That does not mean we can just drink out of it. I cannot take my cup, dip it into this water and take a drink. You'll end up getting giardia. You'll get sick for a couple of days, maybe a couple of weeks. You'll end up losing more moisture out of your body, and you'll end up getting dehydrated from that. It'll make you really sick because of all the parasites and the viruses and the bacteria that's in the water we can't see. So we have to purify that water somehow. Obviously, if I can get a fire going, I would just take my bucket, my canteen, and I would go down to the water, fill this up, and boil that water at a hard rolling boil for a minute before, and then let it cool down before I would drink it, okay? I'd end up boiling it longer than that, but at least a minute, okay? Let's say I cannot boil this water, I can't get a fire going. Behind me, you'll see this piece of plastic, guys. What this is a solar still. And we were talking about a solar still on our setup videos. I've created this a couple of days ago. I came down here and dug this pit a few days ago. I just didn't dig it now because nature takes some time. You have to let it go through the process, okay? So what we're gonna do here is I'm gonna show you what the final process is, but then we're gonna backtrack on how this was created and why it was created here and all that sort of thing. But as you can see on my plastic, there's a bunch of condensation. All right, lots of water is evaporating out of this pit, and it's coming up onto the underside of this plastic that's basically airtight. I have it sealed down really well with dirt, as you can see, so not a lot of moisture is escaping from underneath that plastic. And in the center where that rock is, underneath this plastic is a cup, a collection cup. So I have basically lake water in the ground here. It's groundwater. It's right next, my pit is right next to the lake. So I know I have a lot of good water in here. Accessible water. If you were in an area that you didn't have groundwater, you could cut leaves off the trees, put that in there, etc. And I'll show you, I do have some leaves that I've cut and I've put in here as an example. But this naturally backfilled with all the groundwater and the lake water because it's only a couple of feet away from the edge of the lake, and I've dug it down below the surface of the water level here. So it's filled back in on its own. So all of this water inside of here is evaporating with the sun, collecting on top of this. And because I have a rock down at the lowest point, it will run down to the underside of that plastic and drip down where that rock is and drip into my collection cup, and I can drink this water now. The trick is to get this cover off of here without contaminating your collection cup inside. All right? So if this was something you were gonna use for a length of time, you don't wanna cover it up, uncover it, cover it up, uncover it every time you wanna get a little half a cup of drink of water. What I would do if this was gonna be a permanent source of water, and if you had, again, it's survival, so you might not have everything with you, but if you're camping and stuff, I keep extra stuff in my camping gear. I keep a length of plastic tubing in my backpack. When I'm gonna go out, this goes into the same pocket as my survival kit, my first aid kit. A length of plastic tube hose. You can use a lot of purposes for this. So you don't have to take this cover off every day to get a drink. All I would have to do would be suck on the end of the hose like a big straw and suck the water out of there that I would need, and then just leave it. I would have good drinking water. Okay, that's if you expect you're gonna have to keep utilizing this. I just covered this up yesterday. I built it on Saturday. It wasn't working real great. I came down a day later. I had some technical difficulties with it. My container was falling over. It wasn't set up right. I had to put some stability underneath it, so my collection pot was sitting solid. And then I covered it back up. So this has been sitting here since yesterday afternoon. So it's had a chance to do its thing and evaporate water and recollect. So I'm not sure how much is in there. We're gonna find out. But again, this is something that is not gonna take place. You're not gonna get good drinking water from this in an hour or a half hour, 2 hours. This is gonna take a process of part of a day. So you're better off if you can build this in the morning. And then by maybe that afternoon and evening, you've got some water, okay? So we're gonna take the cover off this thing. I'm gonna be really careful to not contaminate my collection vessel that's inside of there. I'm not gonna get a bunch of dirt in it. I don't want the underside of this plastic to drop down into the water that's inside of here. I wanna try to keep it as clean as possible, all right? So let's take it off here and see how much good drinking water we were able to collect. These rocks, first thing I'm gonna do is try to get all the extra water off of here because there's still a lot of moisture right here. You can see all the condensation. I'm gonna try to tap that and let that run down here because right now I need some water. So there's plenty of water in there. Doesn't smell real great, but I'll guarantee you can drink this. So this has been set up for almost 24 hours and there's only about this much water in this cup. So a larger area, a larger pit, larger sheet of plastic would work to collect more water. But for there to have not been any water in this cup yesterday in 24 hours, now I've got at least this much. We're doing okay. Remember, if you're sweating that much out, that's not gonna help you out. You've gotta drink as much as you're sweating out, okay? So you guys see that there's some water in there. Now you're saying, Ranger Jason, that looks disgusting. That looks dirty and stuff. I'm like, well, okay. Yeah, there's a little bit of sand down in there. There's some stuff that's run down in from the underside of the plastic, but it's not contaminated water. That's just some dirt that was in, that got in from dripping in there. Now, is this gonna taste like your tap water or good water out of your sink? Probably not. It's not gonna be that tasty, but this is a life and death survival situation, folks. It's either drink this water that you've evaporated and collected, or somebody's gonna end up coming across your remains out in the woods because you've dehydrated and succumbed to the elements outside. So wilderness survival is just that. It is not fun and games. It takes a lot of practice and it's life or death. It's survival situation. So I'm gonna have a glass of water. I've been sweating a lot today. And that's not too bad. Has a little bit of a plastic taste to it because of it running down the sheet of plastic. But it kind of reminds me of being a kid drinking out of the garden hose out in the yard when, you know, you get thirsty out in the yard, you just used to go drink out of the rubber garden hose. So this is gonna save my life, I guarantee it. So we've taken the cover off of this solar still area and I wanted to just run through the process of how this was built and how this was designed. Obviously we have a hole in the ground that I've dug, okay? And like I said, I used a shovel. If you're in a survival situation, you might have to use a stick, a rock, or something to gouge out a pit in the ground. But we started with, I wanted to build it down here by the edge of the lake because I knew I didn't have to dig very far to get to the groundwater. I mean, the groundwater here is just the same water that's in the lake. It's just seeped in through the soil. If you're doing this in an area that you don't have a lot of groundwater this close to the surface, that's okay if you have vegetation. And I threw some vegetation in here just as an example. All right, just an example. If you cut tree branches that have nice big wide leaves, broad leaves that have a lot of surface area, the bigger, the wider the leaf, the surface area, the more moisture there is in that leaf, okay? So you could pull all these off the branches, you know, throw those down in the pit if there was no water in there, and fill that up as much with as much vegetation as you can get into that pit. And again, the bigger, the broader the leaf, the better. All right, this happens to be basswood, which has a nice big broad leaf. Okay, but it only took me a couple of feet of digging before this area started backfilling with natural groundwater or lake water, okay? And again, I'm not drinking that water, I'm drinking the evaporated water out of it that's collecting on the underside of my plastic and running back down into the cup that I had set right here. And the plastic was sitting over top of it, and the stone on the top of the plastic was directly over top of that cup. So as that water was collecting, it was running down and dripping back into that cup, okay? Now, for this purpose, I used a cement block as a flat area. You definitely have to have an area in the center that is gonna support your collection vessel, whether it's a small cup or a large camping pot, you know, water pot or something. If you don't have anything, you might have to fabricate something out of the wild, but you could do this at the ocean with salt water, and it will distill the salt out. It'll separate the salt from the fresh water as it's evaporating. The salt would stay in the pit, your fresh water would evaporate, collect, and run back down. Your salt would stay down in the pit. So it's pretty cool. Contaminated waters, yes, to an extent. You want to get the best, freshest source of fresh water that you can. But again, as you remember, I said it several times, you still cannot drink that water without purifying it, okay? But as you can see here, I've got a rim here like a volcano. I set my collecting cup down in the center, about as center as I can get it. I'm gonna be very careful. I'm covering this back up so I'm not getting a bunch of sand and dirt and debris and yucky stuff on the backside of my plastic, because all that dirt's gonna run back down into my drinking water. And then when I cover that up, you saw it covered up before, but I just wanna show you, when you do cover it up, you want it to be tight. You want it to be kind of as tight as you can. And when you weight this down and cover it back up with dirt, you want it to be tight. And you want to seal it up. You want as much dirt all the way around it so that your moisture is not escaping out of the sides. It's not evaporating out of the sides. You want to weight it down. And then again, right above your collection rock, I can see my blue cup right there. That's where I would set my rock. And that's going to weight it to the center, and gravity is going to force all the water down to the center of that and run and drip down, because that's the lowest point to collect. So just a real simple design on how to find some fresh water, how to get drinking water when you are in a situation where you have none and it's going to be life or death. So I like to find different ways where I can find what I need from nature to survive. Some helpful tips for you to survive in the outdoors. I hope you enjoyed watching this. And again, before you go trying to make a solar still at home, make sure you have permissions from your parents, from your grandparents, your aunts and uncles, whoever it is that you live with. Don't just go dig a big hole out in your mom's rose garden. So, and say, Ranger Jason said it was okay that I could come up and dig your landscaping up because I'm gonna make a solar still. So make sure you have permission, and if you have any questions, follow the links, and that'll help you plan your way through some of these fun activities. So until next time, we'll see you. Be safe, have fun, come back out and visit me at Ligon real soon.